And that is DNA, or biological information. In fact, scientists, I'm sure you read about this not long ago, finished mapping the human genome. And it was very interesting. The human genome is the blueprint inside every cell that explains how to build all the proteins in your body. And I love the words of President Clinton when they announced this breakthrough. They'd actually mapped the human genome. He said, "Today, we are learning the language in which God created life." And that's exactly true. DNA is quite literally language. It's language. Inside every one of your 100 trillion cells in your body is this famous double helix of DNA. And if you were to open it up and stretch it out, it would stretch out 6 feet long inside every one of your cells. And it is encoded with a 4-character chemical alphabet that precisely spells out the assembly instructions for all of the thousands of different kinds of proteins out of which your body is constructed. In fact, DNA is the most efficient information storage system in the universe. Our science cannot come anywhere near replicating the ability of DNA to contain information. I'll give you an example. This will blow your mind. Picture a teaspoon of peanut butter. You know what that looks like? A teaspoon of peanut butter. Now imagine that's not peanut butter. Imagine that is pure DNA. How much genetic information could that teaspoon of DNA hold? Just one teaspoon of DNA could hold all of the precise assembly instructions for all of the proteins of every one of the 1,000 million species of animals that have ever existed on the planet and still have information left over for all of the information in every book ever written. That is how efficient DNA is in storing information. It's absolutely mind-boggling. Now, how does DNA point toward God? Well, think about this. How many people saw the motion picture Contact? Anybody ever see that movie? Wow, more than I thought. It didn't do that well. That's kind of surprised. Well, the movie Contact is based on a book by Carl Sagan. And in this movie and in the book, scientists are trying to find out, is there intelligent life anywhere on the planet? And so they have these radio telescopes that are scanning the sky for any kind of sign of life. But all they receive is static, just random sounds. And they make the very reasonable conclusion that there's no intelligence behind these random sounds. That's just a sound that is out there in the universe. But then one day, they begin receiving a transmission of prime numbers. Prime numbers are numbers that are divisible only by themselves or by the number one. So they start getting these numbers coming at them. And the scientists reason, and again, this is quite rational, they reason it is far too improbable that there be natural causes behind a string of numbers like that. This wasn't disorganized static. This was information. This was a message with content. And from that, they concluded there must be an intelligence behind these numbers. Carl Sagan himself said, look, the receipt of a single message from space would be enough to know that there's intelligence out there. But, friends, what is DNA? It is a message with content. It is a language. Just like English uses a 26-letter alphabet, DNA uses a 4-letter chemical alphabet. In fact, inside every cell of the human body is as many words as you would find in thousands of editions of your Sunday newspaper. It's the specific, detailed, written instructions for how to